Hello friends, this video on NEET Ecology is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. We will discuss about the adaptations of halophytes. Now before that, what do we mean by halophytes? So halophytes are the plants which survive in saline habitats. Saline habitats are those habitats which have very high salt content. So high salt content habitat. So the plants in such areas are halophytes. For example, some of the examples of saline habitats could be the saline ponds or the seashores or marshy areas. So these are all examples of saline habitats. In fact, mangroves, that is the marshy areas, are called mangroves. That also falls under the category of saline habitat. So plants growing in these kind of habitats are halophytes. Now, it's quite amazing to see that in these kind of habitats where you do not have a lot of water, you have muddy and marshy areas, less water, but still there are certain types of plants which are very well able to survive and grow there. So let us quickly look at their adaptations. How have these plants adapted to this environment? So their first adaptation is they possess succulents in leaves, stems, or both. Now what do we mean by succulents? Now succulents is basically a phenomenon where those parts of the plants have cells of larger size so that these large size cells can store water. So the succulents property basically helps the plants to store and retain water for quite some time. And the presence of so much of water also helps to dilute salts, because as you see that in these kind of marshy areas or seashores, you do not have sufficient water, but the plant needs sufficient water for its growth. So what do? The parts of the plant have cells of larger size, and the cells would store some water, they would retain some water within them. And this water will also help to dilute salts, and this water will also help the plant in its survival and growth. So what do these plants do? They have succulent parts, that is, they have succulents in different parts. Like some of them have succulent leaves, some have succulent stems, some have both succulent leaves as well as succulent stems, so that the leaves and stems can store and retain water for quite some time. Halophytes also secrete salts, because as I said that they survive in saline habitat, right? So saline habitat has so much of salt in it. Now the too much of salt content is not good for the plant's growth and survival. So what would the plant do with so much of salts? So they kind of secrete salts from their body. And how do they do that? So for secretion of salts, they have specialized glands which are called salt glands. In fact, they are also known as chalk glands. So the purpose of the salt glands or the chalk glands is to secrete excess of salts from the plants. In fact, there are certain plants which also excrete the salt through their epidermis, that is the outer layer of their skin. So through the epidermis also they sometimes excrete excess amount of salt. They have thick cuticle. So what cuticle is? Nothing but a waxy layer outside the body. So why do they have cuticle? So that they can prevent water loss from their body surface. So to prevent water loss. Now why do they want to prevent water loss? Now that's primarily because, as I said, that in these saline habitats, even though they have too much of salt content, but the water content is comparatively lesser. So these saline habitats can be considered as physically wet habitat. Like physically you see water existing there. For example, seashores or marshy habitats, they are not dry habitats physically. So physically they are wet habitat, but physiologically they are dry habitat because they do not have sufficient water also. And that is the reason that many of the adaptations of halophytes are quite similar to the adaptations of xerophytes, that is the plants which survive in deserts, because in deserts also there is no water. But here in this case, the habitat has water but less water. So thick cuticle will prevent water loss from the surface so that more and more water can be retained inside the body of the plant. Sunken stomata. So again, sunken stomata's purpose is also to prevent water loss, because stomata are the tiny pores through which transpiration also takes place, like the loss of water from the surface of the leaves happen. Now, if the stomata itself is sunken, so the loss of water would also be less. So, water loss will be prevented. Organic solutes like proline, sorbitol are present. Now, what do these organic solutes do in halophytes? Well, these organic solutes help in osmoregulation. Now, you might ask, what is osmoregulation? Now, since here we are talking about saline habitats where you have salt and water. Now, it is very important to maintain a constant osmotic pressure in fluids of the organism. That is, it is very important to maintain or to control the water and salt concentrations. So that maintenance, osmoregulation is that process in which a constant osmotic pressure is maintained in fluids of an organism by controlling the water and salt concentration. And who does this? This is done by organic solutes which are present in halophytes like proline and sorbitol. So this is their purpose. So that, you know, because if the concentration of water decreases too much inside the body, so that's harmful for the plants. Similarly, if the concentration of salt increases too much inside the plant body, that is also harmful for the plant. So just to maintain decent concentration of salt and water, this osmoregulation has to take place, and these organic solutes help in the process of osmoregulation. Some halophytes also have pneumatophores. Now, what are pneumatophores? Pneumatophores are specialized roots which help in gaseous exchange. Now, why are they specialized roots? What is their specialization? Now, the speciality of pneumatophores is that they are negatively geotropic roots, because normally the roots grow under the ground, right? So normally roots are positively geotropic because they grow towards the ground, but pneumatophores are negatively geotropic. That means they grow vertically upward. So they are vertical roots. They can also be called as aerial roots because they grow towards the air. Now, how do they help? How do these roots which are growing upwards will help the halophytes? Now, they have small pores on them. The roots themselves have small pores on them, and those small pores are called lenticels. And these lenticels help in gaseous exchange. So that is how these roots help the plants. So if you want, we can have a look at a picture which shows the pneumatophores. So if you look at this tree, you actually see these small roots which seems to be emerging out of water. So what are these roots? So these are seen in the mangrove plants, the plants growing in the mangrove areas, that is the marshy regions. They are the mangroves. So you see they have water, but not too much of water, and you see that these are the roots. So these are the pneumatophores, these structures which you see, and they have small lenticels, and the lenticels help in gaseous exchange. So this is another adaptation of halophytes. Halophytes exhibit viviparity. Now, what is viviparity? So viviparity is a very specialized adaptation of mangrove plants. Now, viviparity is seed germination while the plant remains attached to the parent plant. That means the seedling, like we all know that what happens during seed germination, the seed grows to a seedling, then the seedling grows to a small plant, and then the small plant gradually grows to become a mature plant. So that's the process of seed germination, right? Now in viviparity, what happens is the seedling grows quite big, or it grows quite enough, and till that time it remains attached to the parent plant. So the seedling grows enough before it falls into the saline marsh. So only when it is like grown enough, only then it separates from the parent body. So let us look at this example. So here you can see the concept of viviparity. So you see here, these are the seedlings. So these are the seedlings, and they are attached to the plant even when the seedlings are growing. So until seedling grows enough, they would not fall into the saline marsh. Now once they fall into the saline marsh, the radical part goes into the mud, and the radical part gives rise to root, and the plumule part is above the surface, and it gives rise to the shoot system. Now some of the examples of plants which exhibit viviparity are rhizophore, Cereops, So these are some examples of mangrove plants showing viviparity. So these are some of the important adaptations of halophytes which enable them to survive and grow in saline habitat, that is habitat with high salt content. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.